I'm Professor Felicity Baker, and I'm Head of Music Therapy at the University of Melbourne. By 2050, there'll be almost 900,000 Australians who are living with dementia.
I'm Gwladys McLaughlin. I've got Alzheimer's, and it is a form of dementia. Once I came, I just loved it the first day. Everyone just sings, and it's so happy, and then we have a cuppa and go home and wait for next week.
One of the unique things about music is that it's connected very much with our memories and our emotions. And you can actually see them visibly change. And so you start to see the person behind the dementia.
I can remember I was in this place where I drive, and all of a sudden I sort of felt, I don't know where I am, you know. And so over the years, I knew I had a problem. And then when my husband died, I knew I was in trouble because he was my great carer.
We've got funding to support the largest music therapy trial of people living with dementia in the world. Music has this capacity to stimulate the pleasure centre, the sex, drugs and rock and roll centre of our brain. And so when we use music that we connect with, it affects our moods because it activates those pathways in our brain. And that they seem to be relatively preserved despite the progression of people living with dementia. So our number one rule is to choose music that was special and meaningful to them when they were in their late teens and early 20s.
I think it's the friendship. You can tell everybody just loves it. So.
Treating dementia is expensive. If music can have the same impact as these other forms of treatment, then it's obviously going to be a much more cost-effective approach.
One of our people who's from another country had someone here that started to sing a folk song in the language, and her husband, who is, he's got the sort of dementia where there's no expression on the face, and when she started to sing that song, his eyes opened, then a smile, and then he actually was singing a few words. It was amazing.